Prompto's even capable of hunting alone these days. He really has come a long way.
Had to become a functioning adult sooner or later.
Doesn't feel like you've changed, though.
Not nearly as much as he claims.
You gonna spoil my moment?
What's there to spoil?
You know, even after all this time, you guys haven't changed a bit.
Not as individuals, perhaps, but we no longer need to ask one another for help in times of need. We've reached the point where that sort of synergy is second nature.
Yeah. And it only took us 10 years to get here.
We've even got some former Imperials fighting for us. The toughest of them said she used to lead a band of mercenaries.
Aranea?
So you do know her. Well, I'm not surprised. The Marshal said she was feared far and wide back in the day. But now she's revered among the Lucian masses. Same with her men, Biggs and Wedge. Each of them leads their own small army.
That's great.
I'm more than happy to tell you safe travels, Your Majesty. I'm more than happy to... about the Empire.
Huh.
Gladio brought back word that both the Emperor and High Commander were dead. With those two gone, Niflheim pretty much fell apart.
Yeah, figured.
I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. The Chancellor's still around, though. In Insomnia. Nobody who saw him had any clue what he might have been up to. Their stories piqued Ignis's curiosity. I ended up helping Ignis look into the matter, digging through old records, even joining him on trips to the royal tombs.
Royally roped into it.
It's cool. I'm a bit of a history buff myself. But we did discover something pretty weird.
Huh?
While we were poring over all those ancient texts, one name caught our eye. Ardens. Apparently he was hailed as a savior, healing all those who were ravaged by demons. Only to end up branded a demon himself. A dubious charge, I'd say. By all accounts, he was just as human as you and me.
Huh.
I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. On the bright side, we've come a little closer to understanding the demons.
And?
You see, I'd always thought they were animals. Only more hideous and savage. But it turns out they're just ordinary people. Unlucky folk infected by something or other that transform them into monsters. There's no known cure as of yet. So death is the only mercy. I'm more than happy to tell you, we've got a lot of survivors pouring in from Accordo, too. What with all the demon attacks there as of late? Not like it's much better here. Lestalem's practically overflowing with refugees from Insomnia. The Empire's recovery assistance fell by the wayside, and demons overran the city. Thankfully, Iris and the Marshal managed to evacuate the civilians. Now there's no one left, except the demons. I spent my childhood in the Crown City. It's sad knowing it's gone, you know?
Not for long. I became the king to reclaim our home, and now I'm back, as promised.
All these years and you remembered.
You bet.
I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. Your Majesty, do you remember my grandfather?
Yeah.
There's something I wasn't able to tell you back then. Grandpa died because of me. It was my fault. An Imperial officer approached me in town, asked if I was from the Crown City, and that was just the beginning. What brings you here, young man? You didn't come here by yourself, did you? Oh, your grandfather's a butler at a manor. How very grand. Oh, he rubs shoulders with the royal family. You must be ever so proud. I answered him without thinking. A little after that, the man showed up at our hotel.
Talcott.
Think what you will of me, but please know that Grandpa didn't give you away.
Listen.
Yeah?
You're not a kid anymore. You should know by now what happened that day wasn't your fault. None of it. You know, it's hard to ask someone about their pain, but it's just as hard to share your own with someone else. I appreciate you opening up to me, and I swear I'll make things right. But believe me when I say nobody blames you. Not me, not your grandpa. Trust me, you have the king's word.
I suppose you're right, Your Majesty. Thank you. Safe travels, Your Majesty.
Well, fellas, we're homeward bound at last. Time to suit up.
Finally get to rock these threads.
Wear them with pride.
Yeah. Just hope they still fit.
Home sweet home.
Yeah, at long last.
What we've been waiting for.
Sure is.
Next stop, the Citadel.
Yeah.
This is it. Give it your all, guys.
Yeah.
You got it!
With pleasure.
Together like this in ages.
Really takes you back, doesn't it?
We may have struggled before, but now nothing can stand in our way. Some Z's here.
Certainly. It's a spot worth taking note of.
Thank you. rest.
Just the thing.
Guess we've still got a little fight left in us.
You say that like we've already peaked.
Yeah, we haven't even reached our prime.
Guess you're right.
Let's take it down to the underground. Waiting for this.
Sorry to keep you.
What's a minute after 10 years?
Takes a lot out of me. Huh?
Remember when we used to hang out here?
Yeah, like every day.
And the prince worked part-time nearby.
Wearing a scowl on his face the whole time.
Hey, I smiled as much as I could.
Used to frequent a joint around here, but those days are over.
So there was fighting in the streets.
10 years and you're still acting like a kid.
Come on, Noct!
Got a good thing going here.
Let's have the power of make it through here.
Think there's any other way around?
We might want to head under.
Wow, it's one hell of a battle they waged here.
It's worn down, but still the same.
Just like I remember.
Always came in handy.
Used to be filled with people. Let's see that it is again.
Kingly confidence you've acquired.
And it only took you 10 years. Slowing my legs down.
Fight through it. Can't make it without you.
Ah, yes, sir. Yeah. Majesty.
Well, well.
My god, Sam. You got it.
Got it!
No.
Prompto.
Yeah. We've still got a little fight left in us.
You say that like we've already peaked.
Yeah, we haven't even reached our prime.
Guess you're right. A good place to come when we need a rest. Still think back to all the good times we had at camp.
Staying up all night, sleeping in all morning.
We certainly lived at our own pace.
Those were the days.